I just had a quick talk here at Interactive Cologne about hackers and nerds and geeks. And so on the outside we have the wording of a nerd, and the nerd is usually the typical guy in the basement, which is just coding and hacking with his big glasses and so on. And I said, this is not what a programmer in a startup is right now. These are different people, so we need a different word for it. So, and I call them geeks. Basically, my definition is a geek is a nerd with a girlfriend. And what I mean is, so we have enough social competence to work in a startup, to party hard all the success that they had, and work together with partners, with a team, with all the other guys. So the stereotype of a nerd is totally different. And also hackers, not the right wording perfectly, because on the outside, people are thinking on the illegal people hacking my passwords and all this stuff. So on the internal, it's kind of cool to say, hi, I'm a hacker, but on the outside, he should better say, hi, I'm a geek. So on the definition, it's not perfectly good as well, because it's more like a guy who was in the school, the one who was always raising the hand. So, but the word becomes better now. Like you?
Yeah.
You were one of the geeks, yeah.
I'm Tobias. I've been speaking about founder stories here at Interactive Cologne, and I rather give the economic side of the story, telling some stories how we raised capital, the obstacles you might face, and about passion. So actually I'm the, not to say counterpart, but the second part of a company that will make the perfect synergy from hackers or geeks and entrepreneurs from a business side of the case. I actually met 3 years ago Holstein, a Swedish guy who founded letsbyte.com. Mm-hmm. And he's now an investor himself, and he says the perfect team consists of two techies and one economics guy. And the techies, one is introverted and the other one is rather outgoing, but he founded like 50 years ago, and he said I can spot the outgoing one by seeing where he looks at. The introverted is looking at his own foot tips, and the outgoing one is looking at your foot tips. But I think that changed dramatically. If you look around at these people here, it's hard to spot the coder and hard to spot the not coder in this kind of area.
Absolutely, yeah, that was the baseline in my talk as well, saying that the MBAs need as well a geek. So there are lots of MBAs out there which don't have a geek in their team, and they want to go with an online startup on the market. So they have to given contracts to someone on the outside for make the core of his company. So it doesn't make any sense. And even if it is not an online startup, usually you have a website or you have an app, or you at least do a little bit of online promotion. So when you have a geek in the team, so he's able to combine the stuff, to invent something new, use the existing APIs to be ahead of the others. So the one startup without any knowledge about technology, and the other one which really has a cool guy on board. So that would be the heroes that make perfectly sense in the combination of both.
Absolutely. Yeah, I totally like that concept. I think it's a great idea to have it covered in an entire week around the topic of changing society, disrupting technology, and bringing together the geeks and the MBAs. That happens not very often. You either have an entrepreneurs event and you will not spot any hacker, or you otherwise have the hacker event and you won't spot any guy from the entrepreneurial field, classically. And I totally like that idea and the concept. I miss a little bit the matchmaking. I'm really looking forward to the dating game later. I think that's a great idea to make that match. And actually, that is something that is still lacking in the industry. You will find a lot of geeks out there that have a great idea, but they don't know how to leverage on it because they are so in love with the product, which is great and which is essential for the company. But they might be too much in love with the product to really make money out of that. On the other hand, you have a lot of business geeks who totally believe in their topic of a market, but they do not spot how easily it could be translated into code. And this is something that is really breathtaking. I think there's only a window of 5 years where you can create so many good ideas and make them come true with ridiculously less resources. Using a laptop and a book, and you learn to code. Somewhere out there, there's sitting an 11-year-old boy. He starts to code, and he will have tonight Hello World on the screen, and he's proud as never before. In 5 years, he will create a web page that will use in 6 years of this time every day. And that won't happen in 10 years. It's not that easy to invent something in biotechnology only with a laptop being 11 years old. And it wasn't possible 20 years back when you had to create hardware or cars or whatever. Now you just need a $200 laptop and you get started. And matchmaking events like this one are the key for success.
And that really works out. So there are both sides here. So it's a little bit separated still. So the geeks are sitting there with their laptops, so in a long row over there. And the MBA is staying outside and talking and networking and doing the stuff, which was my talk about as well, so that they need to come closer together and learn how to pitch and how to network between each other. So it's great that it's in a Cologne area. So it's bigger than Berlin, as we say. So since a round of Cologne is from Bochum to Düsseldorf to whatever, 15 million people. So they can make everything what they want even better than in Berlin in some cases, because we have a lot of media industry and stuff like this here. So Interactive Cologne is the first time, so everything is a little bit they're trying to match everything, so it's of course lack of organization somewhere, but that's the charm as well. So it makes sense, there is a platform for it. You're right, the dating game will be a lot of fun, which is Herzblatt with Rudi Carrell, but just I'm the showmaster, not Rudi Carrell, of course, and we will have a lot of fun, I'm sure.